one section, and there's not much area for them to move. The police officers are, having the thinking the people in the front row are actually trying to start an altercation, but it's not. It's the force of the crowd. So that the police department has got to leave an area for those people to move into away from the police officers. And as you can see here in the picture now, you see them moving to the left. Maybe the police officers had opened an area for them to be able to escape from. And that's
Poppy, it looks like sort of they provided an, it looks like they've kind of provided an escape valve, if you will, to allow the group to continue to move on. Do you know where they're now heading?
I don't. I'm walking alongside them now, but absolutely, they were sort of stuck in the same place for the last 20 minutes. Now it seems part of that line of police has cleared and let them through. Again, what they're walking on now and where we're walking beside them is basically a frontage road right next to the highway. So they have not yet entered the highway. I don't think the police would let them do that. Let me just ask someone with me. Excuse me, sir. Do you know where you're marching right now? I know they just let you through. You were being held back before. And what's the goal? Where to go to now? Okay. He doesn't want to say where they're going now. Let me ask one other person. Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where you're marching right now? No. And do you know why? Did you see some of the confrontations back there? Do you know why it got like that? It escalated because it was peaceful for 2 hours.
They spray mace. They
spraying mace, and it don't make no sense. We're out here for justice. It don't make no sense not to be spraying mace and trying to hit us. It don't make no sense. I don't want cameras in my face.
Okay, understood. And Anderson, I do want to be respectful of some of the people here don't want to be on camera, and they have that absolute right. So we're going to pull away so they're not on camera right now. But I will tell you, look, I was very encouraged all afternoon seeing how peaceful these protests were. And then the last 20 minutes it escalated. But I am, from what I can see right now, they're continuing on what has been a largely peaceful march.
Yeah, it certainly seems like kind of a cordon has been opened, but the highway that you said that they were trying to get on, they are not getting on that highway. Is that correct, Poppy?
No, I mean, absolutely not. Look, I'm not with all of them, but where I am right now is with the majority of them, and they're not trying to get on the highway anymore, as far as I can tell, Anderson, no.
Okay, Poppy, I want to appreciate your efforts. We'll continue to follow this in Philadelphia. I want to go to Miguel Marquez, who is here in Baltimore and has been now for many days, as you know. Miguel, where are you? What are you seeing tonight?
We are in Pennsylvania and north, about 1,000 protesters from here at one point, marched all the way down to City Hall and then back to here. And now they have gathered. This is the place, sort of the epicenter of it all. The place where they protested, the place where it became most violent, the place where the CVS burned down. And now it's believed, or people here hope, that it's now a place of renewal. All four corners here are now sort of jam-packed with people from the march. People don't want to go home, and they're waiting, I guess, for the curfew again to start. There are police lined up around the way that will probably eventually clear this area. And I will tell you that the information that has been leaked out there today of the people in this march are not particularly happy with what they have heard with regard to Mr. Gray and whether or not the injuries were self-inflicted. They don't believe that is the case, and I think it's going to be very, very difficult for individuals here to believe that. They say that they will keep up these marches, clearly much more organized than we have seen in days past. They have another one planned for tomorrow, a Saturday, a big rally. Saturday should be a very big rally with lots of activities as well, downtown at City Hall. All of this putting a lot of pressure on the government here to have that report and come up with some charges.
Freddie ain't kill himself.
And that's sort of the sense that you get from everybody in this neighborhood. That
Freddie ain't kill himself.
That Mr. Gray could not have done that to himself, and that is the anger. If that is the conclusion, it's going to be a problem. Anderson?
Miguel, that information, which people thought some information might come out tomorrow, clearly the police let out a little bit of information today. I don't know what the intention was, but it certainly, I guess, takes, in theory, could take some of the pressure off tomorrow, correct?
nothing wrong with that shit. Talk with that man.
I think that is the belief on the side of the government. I think people here, there is a great expectation that something is going to happen tomorrow, no matter how many times we say that it's not going to happen tomorrow. And so I think there's a lot of concern. Well, that's exactly it. This is exactly it. They don't believe that that is going to be the case. And if they don't get some justice tomorrow, they're going to have concerns. And this idea that Mr. Gray did this to himself is an issue.
The police not getting charged.
All right, Miguel, thank you. We'll check in with you. We're on for 2 hours tonight. I want to go back to Poppy Harlow now in Philadelphia. Poppy, clearly it seems the crowd continues to be on the move. What's the scene?
It does continue to be on the move, and here's the thing, Anderson. Earlier, the police had blocked off some of the streets so no cars would go down, so the protesters could walk with no cars. Here's what happens when you run into, you know, traffic at the end of the workday. Some of the drivers here are supporting them, honking their horn, waving at them, and some of the drivers are stuck here. Look, this continues to be, and I want to emphasize, a largely peaceful protest. There was a clash back there. It lasted for about 20 minutes. I could not see from my vantage point, nor have we heard from the Philadelphia police if there have been any arrests. But what has continued is a largely peaceful protest, and that is what police wanted here. This all began with a big rally of about 600 people, Anderson, at City Hall this afternoon at 4:30 p.m. And it is continuing into the night. There is no curfew here. Police have said they'll let it go as long as it is peaceful. And from all of the protesters I've spoken with, there is no specific end goal of where they want to end up tonight. They're just continue to march together.
Is it clear to you, was this initially organized kind of over social media, as we've seen with many of the protests in many of the cities over the last several days?
Yeah, absolutely it is. It was formed by a group called REAL, a group that was formed after the events in Ferguson, Missouri. They put it out on social media. About 2,000 people were expected to come. I can't tell you if that many were here. You have better aerial vantage point than we do, but it was absolutely organized on social media. In terms of why people are here, I think that's important to talk about on a night like tonight. Why they are here, it's a number of different reasons. A white woman, middle-aged, Kimberly, told me she was here with her daughter because she loves this city and she feels like in this city, just like in Baltimore, there are two cities. There is such an economic inequality and disparity, and believes that opportunity is at the root of this, Anderson, and that's what's been echoed to me from people of all ages here in this march.
Poppy, I appreciate your reporting. We're going to check back in with you to see how this march progresses. We're going to take a quick break. We'll also be checking back in with everyone throughout the next 2 hours as we head into the curfew here in Baltimore. Coming up next, the facts of the Gray case. There's a lot of facts we do not know, and I think it's very important to stress that. There's a lot that simply is not known. As we said, the police gave out some more information today. It's actually angered some people, the way that information was released, the intent perhaps behind it. We'll talk about that, tell you all the latest ahead.